Hey guys, and welcome back to Minecraft. My name is Twitchi and we are playing on my publicly available server. If you want to come and join in, there will be details around. But after a couple of very, very cursed episodes, and we'll go into exactly how cursed in a little while, we are back at spawn because you might remember that I was making ourselves a little bit of a battleships game over here. And of course, the next thing we need to do is to put down the maps for making the battleships. Over here, I intend to have a full selection. Of course, to remind you people, you come along, you press the button that you want to make pop up. And can we see it over there? We can't actually see it. Oh, it did a thing. Let's try this corner over here. I missed it. Let's try this corner. I've tested that these were all reachable. There we go. And then I should be able to fly over there and watch. I heard it. I didn't see it. And watch a block come up. There it was. All right, we saw that happen. So, of course, I wanted to make the maps to put this down. But do you know how big a map is? Do you know how big one map could be? Let me go and find a map somewhere. We find ourselves at Landstrider's place here. Wonderful. But he's got these maps here. Now, I don't want one of these ones. I want one of these size maps. And one of these, would you believe, is 8 chunks by 8 chunks. What was that noise? There's a lot going on around here. And 8 chunks by 8 chunks is pretty big to be able to build anything in the overworld. So I am actually going to go off to the end. But first, before we do that, we're going to come over to my chorus farm over here. It's not actually a real chorus farm. I mean, I suppose, yeah, there are real chorus and I can pick them up if I want to, but it's more just a bit of art dressing of the scene, if you will. Anyway, we've got this underground military bunker here, and if I jump down onto the slime and maybe have a little bit of a glide down and under, we come to my equipment room. Inside here, I would like to show you just exactly how the generic cargo box, there we go, cursed last episode was. So last episode, we went out to the end, we raided a bunch of end cities, and I got a whole bunch of equipment. Unfortunately, just after that, I then upgraded the server from 1.19 to 1.19.2. Now, there have been some things in the past to do with upgrades that only affect me, the player. I don't know why it's me. The server doesn't know that I am the server owner. I am just another player as far as the game knows. But somehow it is me and only me that can suffer from such things as having your equipment's enchantments changed on you. If you look through here, you can see that all of what used to be mending is now curse of vanishing, and all that used to be unbreaking is now fortune. In fact, there are just like all sorts of crazy things going on with these. This was my equipment that I had. This is the equipment that I died multiple times to go and get from the end, and now it's just this random stuff. Thankfully, Miss Aligned was online when I found out that this was a situation that I was finding myself in. I'm gonna totally put these on here. I can't put all of them on here. This elytra is the thing that annoys me the most. I say annoys me, it wasn't the end of the world. Like I say, Miss Aligned was on and she could spot me a spare one, but like, oh my gosh, look at that. Curse of Vanishing, fortune three on a pair of wings. So I'm just gonna leave this equipment in here. It's all very cursed. I'm never going to be able to use it. Well, I could use it. There's nothing stopping me using it. It's just, it's so bad. Who wants fortune on their wings? Anyway, that was a little side plot to describe to you guys. So why am I out in the end making Swiss cheese out of some of these end islands? Well, I want to clear map space off, as I've been saying since the beginning of the episode, and coming out to an area that's full of these mini end islands, it's probably the quickest way to be able to clear as much real estate as I possibly can. But there's unfortunately little stubborn bits like this, and there's some over there that I need to get rid of. There are actual land masses. If I take a look down some of these tunnels, you can see that it's very deep. There's like 20, 30, 40 blocks in some places. And I'm far, far, far too lazy to dig that bit by hand. So I've gone ahead and dug maybe one in eight blocks, something like that. We've got nine around the outside, one in the middle, but there's a bit of overlap. I mean, might even be less, might even be more. One in five, because it's the sugarcane spacing, right? One, two, three, four, five, and then the others. Yeah, that's right. That's exactly what's going on. So it's one in five. There we go. You watch me work that out live on video. And we're going to pack it with TNT. We are definitely going to, like, absolutely ram this full of TNT, because we got ourselves a little bit of a problem. If I come over here, dig this convenient little hole that I've got laid out over here, and grab myself a block of TNT, I'm just going to pop this down the bottom here. And now, if this was stone, oh, I'm going to lose some end stone. All right, run away. If this was stone, that would have blown a clear hole through. But as you can see here, I think all we can rely on is maybe a cross here. The middle layer is going to get blown out, and then a cross on top. Quick bit of maths, that makes it about 18 blocks in there. So that's, we've got 19 according to this. All right, maybe I'm mistaken. So filling in my big hole here, we lost a few more than I would have liked. You might notice that all of my items are in pristine condition. That's because I've built myself a scrappy little Enderman farm over here. It turns out you don't need to go off and make yourself a whole, like, control perimeter where nothing else can spawn in the outside. Quite a few Endermen will just spawn in view range of a little farm bug that I've got here and come running up. Now, unfortunately, as I say, it does have a few flaws. Like, these guys down here cannot see this one, but the majority that spawn, because there is nothing, look at this, nothing but end stone between me and the void below, and it's quite a space. So I effectively have a space where only Endermen can spawn right here. They go down, I go down this little water well, which, now that I think about it, I probably should have put an actual drop chute in, maybe right next door. I could just, like, one hit kill these guys. It's the perfect depth. I did have to look that up online first, though. I think it's like 42 blocks. I leave that as an exercise to the viewer to understand that. That should be a quick Google search for you. But I'm not sure about the economics of my little decision here to open up this area, because we're going to get ourselves maybe 9 blocks back. But I need to go and collect a TNT for each end stone that I've mined out. I want to replace all of this with TNT. That's the best part of 3 and a bit shulker boxes. I'm going to get 4 shulker boxes of TNT, but of course 4 shulker boxes of TNT comes at a much higher cost. Who's angry? Why are you angry at me? I'm just going to dive under here and wait and see. You know what? I don't think anybody's directly angry, unless there's someone in this trench here. No, I think I'm safe. But yeah, 4 shulker boxes of TNT, that comes at a cost of sand. I mean, we don't need to worry about the gunpowder. I've got the gunpowder sorted. But sand comes at a significant cost. And so from one barren yellow wasteland to another, I am at the Gathering Desert. I've spent some time leveling this off. No, I don't know why. I mean, I've got some ideas of some plans, but nothing that's actually going to take hold. So yeah, it's time to just go and collect myself, what is it, 4 shulkers of sand for every shulker of TNT I need. That is 16 shulker boxes of sand. I mean, here's some. We'll be right back. Or, you know, maybe I went and got four times that amount. Yeah, we've got soaker boxes full of stuff over here. I even went and got myself all the gunpowder we're going to need. Pushed back the boundary of flatness where I couldn't record. I thought that was a good use of my time. Ripped up all the stone, put down more smooth sandstone. But now I've got to go through and do quite a tedious task. Pull out four of these, pull out five. No, I'm kidding. I've built a machine. Of course I've built a machine. What we need to do, though, is to get all of these shulker boxes from here onto the machine. Ah, oh, look at that. Beautiful. 10 out of 10 would try that magic again. Blatantly stolen from Scar. What I'm going to do is just walk up and press this button here, and instantly the machine starts throwing stuff at me. Oh, man, I'm worried about stuff getting caught. But that's fine. We just hit the TNT block and do that. I'm going to sit here and wait for time for all of these items to be thrown at me. I'm probably going to put some... Let's do this together. It's going to carry on going because I thought the items were going to hit the pressure plate over there. I've got some sandstone here. I'm a little bit scared of all my items being lost. So if we just go along and place this on the side of the redstone there, I should be able to just get back to standing here. Wonderful. And then the only thing I'm really missing is some shulker boxes to put them in. But I think I've got a bunch of shulker boxes doing their thing back here. So eventually I'm going to end up with everything I need. And this is so much better than just standing around. Could you imagine all the different like how much time it would have taken to just like click on these, click on that, click on these, click on that? Because I wouldn't be able to fill myself. I would have to take five out of here and then four out of there, or multiples of, but no more than like we could have three at a time if I had emptied all of my inventory. Why am I not being because I'm not looking in the crafting bench? That really does help. But yeah, I will I'll see you when this is done. I totally should have mentioned, this always dispenses the correct amount. So if I could get this to stop, which I'm only going to be able to do by breaking the signal here, because this will just carry on doing this else, and then craft all of the materials. You can see I've got none left over. That's a beautiful little system there. I think it's amazing. I've got to be honest, I stole this machine. I saw this machine on the internet, and it was just a dispenser per item in your crafting grid, right? I actually got it for sea lanterns over at my guardian temple. But I'm a terrible YouTuber. I forgot to write down their name on the sign. I'm really sorry. I do like to give credit to these things, but this is just like a build upon, this is just me building upon that particular idea. Oh, we finally got it done. That was the best part of half an hour. Next time, I am most definitely building this out of double layers of dispensers. All I need to do is have, like this on top and then go down one and push in. But of course, that would mean everything goes up one. But this is a disposable design anyway. So next time, I will definitely keep that in mind. Next thing we got to do is transport all of this to the end. You're thinking that's a lot of TNT? You are correct. Just short of four shulker boxes. Well, three and a half shulker boxes. I don't want to oversell this here, but it's still one of the largest explosions. This is what I've got left from three shulker boxes. One of the largest explosions that I've ever had the pleasure to set off on this particular server. I have no idea what's going to happen. I thought long and hard about whether I was going to set fire to this from the inside or the out. We're going to go from right there. All right, I am out of here. We, of course, have the replay mod running. I am a little bit worried that maybe we're going to start blowing stuff up everywhere. Oh no, my shulker boxes. But I think we should be fine. Oh, it's dangerous. Oh man, that is dangerous. I might start taking flight. Oh man, oh, they're going to be angry at me because I set the explosion off. Oh yeah, that's great fun. Okay, I want to watch, but I also have an Enderman following me, so I think I'm gonna have to. Take to the sky. Ooh, explosion to the face. Looking good though. Looking good. Ow, ow. All right. Okay. Too much. I've got to keep clear of the big explosion radius. Let's go up higher. Man, that's a lot of just flying TNT. Oh no. I don't want to die. Over the void would be the worst way to lose my stuff. Wow. I think I have indeed lost those shulker boxes. Let's go and see what's I don't even know if I can get in and grab them quick. Okay. Wow. Oh, what do you mean there's blocks left? Why are there blocks left? Best news though, saved the shulker box for the TNT. Yay. Okay, ignoring the losses of four shulker boxes, and we're in the end. The loss of four shulker boxes is not the end of the world. I feel like that kind of went mostly successfully. I'm not sure why we've got this huge conglomerate of blocks over here that needs to be taken out, but it's large enough for me to land on safely, so I can just go along and take it all out. Water buckets are gonna be my friends here, but yeah, that went really well. Like, really well. How was it out of this whole edge here? It was only my protective bunker that got blown up. Nothing else. Not a single other block. Maybe we can do the next one a little bit safer. Seven and a half hours of blasting later. I think like we are very, very nearly done. When we were blasting over here, it took me on order of 3 hours to get the TNT out, well, all the materials, I should say, the sand, the gunpowder, crafted it all into TNT and got all that together. So I feel like we made a better investment. Plus, of course, I didn't actually have to go and get these materials, but here we go. We've got a blasted out little zone here. You can see them clearing on the maps. Ah, oh, it is beautiful. There's a little bit of mess to tidy up over here, it turns out, but I'll just run the machine for a couple more seconds. That is no problem. But you might be wondering, here near the very end of this particular episode, what were we even doing this for? Do you remember all the way back at the beginning when I was talking about the battleships game? That's right, we are indeed building some giant spaceships. Can I stick the landing here? Now, I hope most of you are familiar with the Lightmatica mod, because it's I've been over in a creative world working on this absolute beast of a machine. What we're looking at here is merely the engines. The engine room. We've got some point defense lasers up on top. If I just kind of come through here, this, of course, all absolutely holographic blocks. Not a single one of these is real in the world. If you were looking in a different account, you wouldn't even see this. This is just to let me know where I am supposed to place some blocks. And it's taken me a long time to work through all of this. So this is what we will be building over the next couple of episodes, as well as a few other things that I have planned. But I completely ran out of time for this episode. I will see you guys next time, where we're going to be, well, look, there's a lot of stone. Over 12,000, hey, let's come in here. Let's come in here. The materials list, let's refresh that. Smooth stone, about 12,000 smooth stone. I need 5,000 concrete, 2,500 andesite. Look at all this iron I need and the iron trapdoors, smooth quartz. We're gonna have to be making some machines to make us some of this stuff, but I will see you then. Oh, and we're gonna do that. Bye!